everybody. This is Christopher with AG Productions. Welcome back to Monster Fest 2018 and a brand new box opening video. Doing a little more artistic inspiration here. Got 9 booster packs of Dark Ascension. We've worked our way, starting with Eldritch Moon through all of the Magic the Gathering Innistrad stuff. Started with Eldritch Moon, moved on to Shadows over Innistrad, then backwards into Avacyn Restored, and finally here into Dark Ascension today. Next week, though, however, we'll move back into the granddaddy of them all, the original Innistrad block. Opening a fat pack from every single set, all the way from ending to beginning. But we've seen some amazing artwork. I expect nothing less out of Dark Ascension. Let's jump inside and see what we've got. So, as we have had before, we've got a nice little player's guide, which gives us history of the set, shows us some cards in the set, that kind of stuff. So we'll set that to the side. We've got a little piece of artwork here, which I won't turn out, but you can see inside there. This is a yet another fold-out poster. You know, if I were to disconnect it right here, could flip that out and have a nice little wall poster with Sorin on it. And then we've got ourselves a card storage container, again, with a good little nice piece of art on the front of it. I really like these art card storage containers. They're very nice. They beat the heck out of those white ones. Really, really nice. All right, and inside here we should have 9 booster packs, spend down life counter, and some deck boxes that won't hold sleeve cards, so they're kind of useless in today's gaming ages, but that's all right. And then we also have a small deck of what appears to be, I believe, 80 land. I can't remember if these were 80 or 100 back in this era, but who knows. Anyway, all right. Get in here. This is all Innistrad land. You can see by the Innistrad set symbol right there. So we'll set that to the side. We won't be seeing that set symbol until next week when we actually open an Innistrad fat pack. I guess I should have left my hobby knife out so I could cut open this pack. There we go. Sort of. There we are. All right. Got ourselves a nice white spin down with this really cool black set symbol on it. I like that. That's very nice looking. Really pretty. Okay. Set that to the side. Pull open the remainder of the packs. And then we also have a getting started guide on how to play everything involved with the set. I actually don't think it has anything about the set on it. I think it's just a guide on how to play. There might be something about... No, there's nothing on the back about the set. So this is just their reference guide as to how to play, which is actually not terrible. It's not, in my opinion, as great as the rule books that they used to produce back in the early days of Magic, but it's still pretty darn good. It's a lot better than the little one-page things that you get nowadays in a fat pack or a bundle, I think is what they call them nowadays. But overall, not bad. All right, so we have a lot of werewolves here. Okay, so let's do, let's do this guy. For now, let's do him last, since he's kind of a one-off. And we'll do werewolf, Sorin, werewolf, Sorin, werewolf, Sorin, werewolf, werewolf. Sure, why not? Alright, I tell you what, so we don't have 2 werewolves in a row, let's put this werewolf on the back. So we got a werewolf between every pack. That's fun. Alright, so let's do, in fact, let's switch around even further. Let's take the middle Sorin and swap him with this blue guy. And now the blue guy is right smack in the middle. There we go. That's what we call obsessive compulsive. But that's okay. Alright, so we got 9 booster packs to go. Let's take a look. Let's make sure I'm lined up here. That's right about where I'm going to be filming, so that's great. Alright, let's see what kind of cool stuff we can see. I love this series. I love these sets. The artwork in them is absolutely astounding. I mean, it's really, really nicely done. The only one, honestly, that doesn't quite fit with the others is Avacyn Restored, and I think it's because it's more of a happy type set. But it's interesting, I was noticing as I was opening the Avacyn Restored stuff last week that there really aren't nearly as many perspective shots where, like, you are in the artwork as there are in at least the Eldritch Moon and the Shadows over Innistrad stuff. I don't really remember Dark Ascension that much, and I really don't remember Innistrad. I've only opened a few packs of each of those, but I found it interesting that when you, as we moved from Eldritch Moon backwards into Avacyn Restored, when we got to Avacyn Restored, there was a the artwork was still really nice, but there was a lost sense of being within the art, which is kind of strange. But again, really great artwork, just a different take on things. So kind of interesting to see how the sets sort of played well with each other like that. So anyway, let's get into this. So we start off with Hunger of the Howl Pack. Morbid, that's an ability I'm not too familiar with. Put 3+1/+1 counters on that creature instead if a creature dies this turn. Okay, so Morbid triggers off of a creature's death. All right, cool. Russet Wolves. 3/3/4/4. Basically hill giants. All right. Black Cat. Love the artwork on this card. I would love to see this in foil. But to me, you know, aside from the really cool, compelling eyes of the cat, what I really love about this is the stonework. Look at how nicely that stone is done. That's a really beautiful piece of rock right there. I mean, it's really, really wonderfully done. It feels like that's a nice, solid piece of stone. I mean, it's a really well-done piece of artwork. David Palumbo, the artist on that one. Very cool. A Shriekgeist. Again, another one that would be an amazing foil. Oh, God, the artwork on this stuff is just fantastic. Absolutely unbelievable. I've got a booster box of all five of these sets. I've actually got several booster boxes of each of them, and I've been hesitant to open them. I was thinking about doing it this year for Monster Fest, but I got to thinking, you know, going through the Fat Packs last year took about 30 to 40 minutes per Fat Pack to do, so doing an entire booster box would probably be a couple of hours, and it would lose some of its compelling nature to watch the entire thing, even for artistic inspiration purposes. But I'm tempted, you know, after seeing all of these beautiful pieces of art, to get in and actually open one of them, because I mean, look at that. That is just stunning. I mean, look at the use of so many different elements here. You've got so many different types of contrast. So first of all, you've got light versus dark. That's the obvious one. You've got this really deep background, even a deep foreground here in the tattered clothes of the Shriekgeist, but coming, emanating from the inside of these clothes is just super, super bright light. So we've got one type of contrast there. We've got another type of contrast in our complementary colors here. We've got blue mixed with this sort of orangish red. So whenever you combine this kind of orange color with a blue, it's going to make one or both of the colors pop, whichever one is the dominant color. So you have here a blue, very dominant color, and you've got just little hints of orangey colors around, little bits, and that brings the blue out even more. And on top of that, you've basically got almost an X structure in the layout of the artwork, which draws the eye to the center right here. It's just, I mean, it's so unbelievably well done. This is technical art at its finest. It really is. Raymond Swanland, the artist on that one. That is an amazing, amazingly beautiful card right there. Oh, it's so pretty. Burden of Guilt. Man, that's just, oh, such gorgeous artwork, man. Rack with Madness. Target creature deals damage to itself equal to its power. Very cool. Divination. I have never seen that divination before. Huh. Pardon me. I'm yawning. It's a late night video. I've seen divination over and over and over again throughout the years, but I've never seen that particular artwork. Very interesting. All right. Sombrevald Dryad. Beautiful piece right there. I mean, just gorgeous. The female form is really well done here. Absolutely beautiful. All right, backing out again. Heavy Mattock. Avacyn's Collar. Now, I've gone through 9 commons based on how I stack them. 3/3/3. Yep, so I've gone through 9 commons. So I'm assuming that there is a foil in here. But I can't remember. It might be that there's a flip card instead, and it's 8 commons if there's a foil. So we'll find out here in a few minutes. So Avacyn's Collar is our first uncommon. That's going to be followed by Altar of the Lost. And Farbog Boneflinger is our final common. I'm sorry, our final uncommon. What is behind this? Is it a rare, or is it a flip card, or is it a flip? Okay, so it's not a flip card. Are there even flip cards in this set? I don't remember. So it's going to be rare. Holy cow, it's a mythic rare. First pack off, we have a mythic rare. What is it? Boom. Macias the Unhallowed. That's pretty cool looking. All right, so we have 3 black and 3. Gives us a legendary zombie cleric. He's a 5/5 with Intimidate, which I think that's fear, if I remember correctly. I think that's what Intimidate is, where he can only be blocked by black and artifact creatures. Whenever a human deals damage to you, destroy it. And other non-human creatures you control get +1/+1 and have Undying. Now, what does Undying do? When a creature with Undying dies, if it had no +1/+1 counters on it, return it to the battlefield under its owner's control with a +1/+1 counter. That is very strong. That is a really cool card. Wow. Man, I like that. That is a really nice card. Okay, kind of expensive, but very, very cool. Artwork on it, not bad. Not bad. I like the detail in the stonework behind him. Take a look over here. You can actually, you have sort of the living form of the same guy. That's very nice how they've kind of combined that. That's very cool. Okay. Interesting. All right. Back out. There we go. Okay. And behind this, what do we have? Is it a flip or is it a foil? Nothing. It's an advertisement. Okay. So that's weird. Pretty advertisement, though. Good use of, again, good contrasting colors. And behind this, what do we have? We have, okay, so there are flip cards. This is a flip card. What kind of flip card is it? It's a common. We have a Scorned Villager. It's basically a Land of War Elf, but extra. Each upkeep of no spells were cast last turn. Transform Scorned Villager. Okay, it transforms into a Moonscarred Werewolf. All right. Pretty cool. And then we have an island, which looks nothing like an island. All right. Very cool. Good strong starting pack there. I like that. Okay. And let's see what we have next. We've got a pack with Sorin on the front. Another Shriekgeist. Again, still a beautiful piece of art. Hadn't changed since the last time we saw one. All right. Hallowhenge Beast. Spiteful Shadows. That's pretty cool. Very interesting. I think it would be, just looking at the artwork, I think it would be a more compelling piece if, instead of having the sword going through his head in the shadows, he's kind of like, he's sort of grabbing his face here, so it might have been kind of interesting to have the sword coming in from the top, like a sword swallower going down, but you would have to change the size of the shadow over here, probably pull him down further into the corner so you could get that sword going down, but I think it would make more sense. In this case, he ought to be grabbing the top of his head, but anyway, it's kind of a cool piece, though. I like it. All right, we have an Erdwall Ripper. That's a very simple piece. I haven't seen something like that since the old Drew Tucker days of Magic. Interesting. Another Divination. A Sanctuary Cat. That's a pretty card. Kesig Recluse. I always think it's interesting. I think I mentioned this in the past, but the artist here is Vincent Prose. I'm curious if that is actually a different artist who, during these Innistrad sets, was going by the name of Vincent Prose in honor of the great horror actor Vincent Price. I don't know, but I think it's kind of interesting. Anyway, moving on. Fling. That is just freaking morbid right there. Look at that. So this dude has had his head removed, and his head is flying towards us, the viewer. That is cool. Man, I like that. I like it a lot. By Izzy. A Tower Geist. Okay, so, alright, so here we have a situation where we had only 8 commons, which means we're going to see a foil in this pack, now that I know the pack layout, roughly. Alright, so that's pretty cool. Tower Geist. Again, love the object source lighting right here. Really, really nicely done. Only the top two cards your library, one on the battlefield. Okay. Mm-hmm. Deadly Allure. Really nice piece of artwork. Steve Argyle. I believe I've heard of him before. It's a very cool cool layout. You don't see the very feminine females in Magic the Gathering anymore. They've done away with a lot of that just due to the, you know, that whole social, I don't even know what to call it, just the idea that, you know, females shouldn't be feminine, that sort of, that concept. But here we have a really nice piece from before that, that time frame. Get a I like it when I see green on a black card. It kind of reminds me of the old Elves of Deep Shadow. I know that was black on a green card, but just kind of, it's a throwback to when I first got into Magic. It was kind of fun. All right, so that's second uncommon. The third uncommon is the Skurzdag Flayer, which I believe that was the guy on one of these deck boxes. Yeah, it's this guy here. So here we got the deck box with that dude on there. Okay. All right. And then behind this, is the rare? Is the foil? Is the flip? I think it's probably the rare. Let's see here. Yeah. Oh. Two mythic rares in a row. Dude, this is crazy. All right. What do we have? It's a green one. We have a Vorapede. Okay. If three green, two colorless mana, gives us a 5/4 insect with vigilance and trample and undying. Very, very cool. Oh, man. That's... wow. Five mana for a 5/4 with vigilance, trample, and undying. Jeepers, creepers. All right, so when there's a foil, is the foil behind... No, we have a token here. Okay, so we have a zombie token. Is the foil behind this, or is it the flip card? No, it's a checklist card. Is there a foil in this pack anywhere? Theoretically, there should be. This is a flip card. Okay, maybe there's not a foil. So maybe... maybe if there's eight commons, maybe you get a token or a checklist card instead. That's really weird. Okay, all right, whatever. Is there a foil? Okay, so there's a foil behind this. So there's no land in this pack. That's really weird. I've never seen them take a land out of a pack to give you a foil. Okay, all right, very weird, but whatever. So here's our flip card. This is the Hinterland Hermit. At the beginning of each upkeep, if no spells were cast, last turn, transform Hinterland Hermit. This, okay, so the foil is not a flip, so I'm going to flip this over and see what this flips into. This flips into the Hinterland Scourge. He must be blocked if able. At the beginning of each upkeep, if a player casts two or more spells last turn, transform Hinterland Scourge. I kind of like this transform ability. It happens on every upkeep, and I've seen it on the other one that we saw in this set. It triggers on every upkeep, not just yours. And it's very random as to how it triggers. So, you know, it's one of those things where you may or may not end up with the card that you want when it comes to being your turn. So that's kind of cool. I think it's fun. I've always liked randomness in Magic the Gathering. I love coin flip cards. I love random cards like World Purge and stuff like that. What's the one of the other ones? Goblin Game. Just weird stuff like that. And so, for me, Confusion in the Ranks, another great one. Stuff like this, I love it. It's very, very cool. There's times when I like control over when things happen, but this kind of adds a fun element to the game. So, anyway, let's move on and see what our foil is going to be. It is a... dude, it's a foil rare. We have hit two mythics, and we're hitting a foil rare, and we're only two packs into this set. This is bonkers. All right, let's see what we got. The Markov Blademaster. Man, would you look at that. And that is the, that's the Black Blade Reforged from Dominaria. I remember seeing that. Wow. Dude, would you look at the foiling on that thing. That is amazing. Markov Blademaster. Okay, it's a 1/1 Vampire Warrior, costs 2 red and 1. It has double strike, and whenever Markov Blademaster deals combat damage to a player, put a +1/+1 counter on it. Not bad. And actually, with double strike, if I'm reading this correctly, if I attack and I hit a player, the first time she hits, it counts as one hit. So you would put a +1/+1 counter on her before the normal damage hits. So now she's hitting for two. And then you put another +1/+1 counter on her. So one damage into your opponent, I'm sorry, one time hitting your opponent gives you a 2/2, 3/3. So it gives you a 3/3 creature. So you bump her up by 2. And you've hit your opponent for 3 damage at one point, at one time. That's pretty cool. So the next time you go in, you're hitting for 3, and then you're hitting for 4, so that's 7. Dude, this is a crazy card, if it works the way I'm thinking of. That is nuts. Man. Now, here's something interesting. The artist on this one, there's actually two artists, Jaina or Yana, I'm not sure which one it is, I'm guessing Yana, Schirmer, and Johannes Voss. Wow. I wonder how they, you know, how they combine their efforts on this card. Let's take a look at it real quick. I mean, aside from the amazing foil work there, which you, I mean, it's, I like it because it's really just the blade that's foiled. And, I mean, you get a little bit of foiling up here in the crown. But, you know, a lot of times commons, for instance, are just, you know, they gloss the whole thing with foil and that's it. But this is really, really nice. Very cool. My goodness. All right. Well, we're just doing super duper here with these Dark Ascension packs. I hope that streak continues. But I mean, we're seeing some amazing stuff too. I know this is going to be a long one. We're 20 minutes into the video, and I've only made it through 2 packs. So strap in because we're going to be here a while. I hope I have enough film or enough hard drive space to film this whole thing. Yeah. Let's see what we got here. All right, moving on. Tragic Slip, one of my favorite cards. I forgot this has the Morbid ability. I forgot what Morbid does. All right, so a target creature gets -1/-1 until end of turn. Unless a creature has died this turn, in which case target creature gets -13/-13. That's freaking awesome. I love it. That is absolutely amazing. All right, so Crushing Vines. Skillful Lunge. Wow, that is a beautiful piece of artwork there, too. Look at that. This is a great one that kind of personifies a couple of different artistic technical things as well. You've got the blue and the red working really, really well together. You've got a lot of sort of neutral tones, not really necessarily neutral, but sort of neutral to yellow tones in the background. You've got this great division line right here dividing light versus dark. You've got this X structure here. You've got this piece going that way, and then you've got this cross piece going into it. You've got the light piece piercing through the dark stuff over here on this side, so it creates this really nice focal point right here. Very, very technically well done piece of artwork right there by Jason Felix. Beautiful, beautiful piece of art. There's a Torch Fiend, which looks kind of like a dragon, although it says he's a devil. Midnight Guard. That's actually one of the few cards that I remember seeing from last year. Midnight Guard. Ulvenwald Bear. Undying Evil. I'm sensing an Evil Dead vibe here. Griptide. Harrowing Journey. And we've only been through 8 commons, so we have ourselves another foil, because we're on an end of the uncommons here already. All right. Next up, Wolf Hunter's Quiver. Okay. This would be, I think, better suited if we had... Well, I guess you can kind of see a hint of silverish. It still kind of looks like metal, but I think it would be very cool if you could like clearly tell that those arrows were silver-tipped. I think that'd be fun. And then another Altar of the Lost. So behind this, again, we should have our rare, theoretically. Okay, it's not a mythic this time, so we've gotten out of mythic range, but what do we have? We have a Havengul Runebinder. So 2 blue and 2 colorless gives us a 2/2 human wizard. You can pay 1 and 2 colorless and tap him to exile a creature card from your graveyard, put a 2/2 black zombie creature token on the battlefield with a plus, then put a +1/+1 counter on each zombie creature you control. That's pretty cool. I think it would be better suited if it was a black card, but I really like the ability. Black and blue zombies. I don't know that I've ever seen that run before. It's normally black zombies or white zombies. Woohoo! Anyway, but cool card. I like it. Okay, so behind this, what do we have? We have an advertisement. And then what do we have? We have a flip card. No, we have a checklist card. Okay, so advertisement and or token, checklist card. Next should be the flip, right? Yep, flippy flippy. We have a Mythic. Again, three packs in. Mythic. Whoosh. Huntmaster of the Fells. Very cool looking card. Very, very traditional style art in its appearance anyway. It may have been done digitally, but just the appearance of it suggests brush and canvas of some kind. Very cool. All right. It's a happy little trees there in the background. Happy little guy with a happy little axe. Happy little clouds in the sky. All right, what do we have? We have a 2/2 human werewolf. He costs one red, one green, and two colorless. Whenever this creature enters the battlefield or transforms into Huntmaster of the Fells, put a 2/2 green wolf creature token onto the battlefield, and you gain two life. At the beginning of each upkeep, if no spells were cast last turn, transform Huntmaster of the Fells. Very, very cool. Again, great random flip mechanic, and you flip this guy back and forth, and you keep getting wolf creatures and gaining life. That's pretty cool. What does he turn into? Let's flip this over so we don't see the foil. He turns into the Ravager of the Fells, a 4/4 werewolf with trample. Whenever this creature transforms into Ravager of the Fells, it deals 2 damage to target opponent and 2 damage to up to 1 target creature that player controls. At the beginning of each upkeep, if a player casts 2 or more spells last turn, transform Ravager of the Fells. Again, very, very strong. You've got this flipping over and over and over kind of thing situation going on. Every time it flips, not only do you get a different type of creature, you get a benefit. One can help you, one can hurt your opponent. Very, very, very cool. Man, that is a nice card. We are doing spectacular as far as Mythic stuff goes. What's our rare, or what's our foil going to be? Is it another foil rare? Because that'd be awesome. No, it's a foil common this time, but that's still cool. It's a Forge Devil. Got a little foilage action going on there in the lava. Pretty cool looking. All right. Man, we're rocking along here. Okay. Put this guy back in its... Could we please go back into the package? Thank you very much for your cooperation. I appreciate it. Jeepers, creepers, I tell you. All right. Oh, we didn't spend 10 minutes that time. All right, so here we got our one-off pack. This is the only pack of this guy that we have. Let's see what we got. Hey, that's the first, like, land card that we've seen other than that that island. Okay, so here we have a land, a Haunted Fengraf. Another Tragic Slip. Faithless Looting. All right, I've used this card many times. I didn't know it came from this set. I have a copy of it from one of the Commander decks. Didn't realize it came from Dark Ascension. A Headless Scab. That's creepy. Silverclaw Griffin. Kessig Recluse. Fires of Undeath. This is one of those, it's almost got this nice vertical division right here, but it's so symmetrical that it works very, very well. Wow, you got black, or you got red card with a black ability on it. Very cool. You don't see that too often. A Young Wolf. Chant of the Skiffsang. That is a really strange name. Skiffsang. All right. Target creature gets -13/-0. I like it. All right. Okay, so we had 9 commons that time. We will not have ourselves a foil, but we do have a card that's got this weird, like, line across it. Can you see it? Right there across the front. If I hold it just right, you can see it. Very odd. Avacyn's Collar. Stromkirk Captain. Hadn't seen that guy yet. Other vampire creatures you control. Plus one. Okay, all right, not bad. Nidless of the Urn. And then behind that we have what? Whoosh. Call of the Kindred. Call to the Kindred, sorry. Again, perspective shot. We are the viewer. There's our hand opening our curtains. And we have all of these crazy things looking in our window at us. Very, very cool. One blue. 3 colorless gives us an aura enchantment and enchants creature. At the beginning of your upkeep, you may look at the top 5 cards of your library. If you do, you may put a creature card that shares a creature type with enchanted creature from among them onto the battlefield. Then you put the rest of those cards on the bottom of your library in any order. I like it. That's very strong. go good in a nice tribal commander deck of some kind, as long as you're running blue. Very, very cool. All right, behind this we have another advertisement slash token card. There's a checklist card. And the land? No, what the hell is this? Oh, it's a flip card. Okay, so the flip card's on the back. We have no land. What's the flip? Chosen of Markov. This is one of my favorite cards. I love the appearance of the colors and everything. The girl's skin is beautifully done. It's very soft and feminine. But the reds combined with the nice like beigey skin tone, and then the little bits of kind of grayish off-white work really, really well together. And she turns into Markov's servant, a slightly less innocent-looking version of the same girl. You would definitely not get away with that kind of a card in Magic the Gathering today. Very cool, though. Really nice pack. I like that one. All right. Moving on. We're in pack number 5 now. Back to the werewolves. Come on. Open up. Dadgum you. Open. There we go. All right. All right. Spiteful Shadows, once again. Seen that already. Erdwald Ripper. Another Black Cat. Break of Day. Creatures you control get +1/+1. Faithful Hour, that's one I haven't seen yet. If you have 5 or less life, those creatures are also indestructible until end of turn. Okay. Hunger of the Howl Pack. Sombreval Dryad. Heavy Matic. Fling. And a Sightless Ghoul. Wow. This has always been one of my favorite color combinations. It's sort of pinkish purple color, black, and like a... like an ochre or a khaki type color. Really, all three of these colors just work. It was very, very well together. I mean, really, really nice. Beautiful card. Svetlin Velinov, the artist on that one. Nidless of the Breath is our first uncommon. That's going to be followed by Grim Flowering. And finally, Village Survivors. I like the tenseness in the picture here. Very cool. They're all, you know, gathered around the fire, but then all of a sudden, whoop, they're looking up at something just slightly off screen or slightly off of the card. Don't know what it is, but they're all very, very, very tense. Maybe they're prepping weapons, you know, that we can't see, about to fend off something. Kind of interesting. All right, rare is going to be what? Curse of Echoes. 1 blue, 4 colorless, enchant player. Whenever enchanted player casts an instant or sorcery spell, each other player may copy that spell and may choose new targets for the copy he or she controls. That's pretty cool. I like that. Behind that we have an advertisement. Behind that we have our flip, the Hinterland Hermit, which I think we've already seen. We have the Hinterland Scourge. And then there's a forest, which actually looks pretty cool. I like the fact that it looks like a forest, and it looks nice and grim looking. Fits the set very well. Okay, moving on. 4 packs remain. Let's see what we have. Open, please. There we go. Stormbound Geist. Pretty cool looking card there. I like that. Followed by another Silver Claw Griffin. Spiteful Shadows. Executioner's Hood. That's a creepy looking card. Dang, look at that. Let me zoom in so you can see some of the detail on that hood. Very, very nice. Very creepy. Bar the Door. This is one of my favorite pieces of art. I remember seeing this last year. Look at that. That is a piece of art that tells a story right there. You've got this fearful guy right here putting his back into the door. These other guys trying to get this bar in place. You get these hands of these creatures breaking through the center of the door, trying to push it open. That is really, really nice. I like that piece of art. That is Ryan Pancoast on that one. Beautiful, beautiful artwork. Kessig Recluse. Another fling. Midnight Guard. Chant of the Skiffsang, once again. Markov Warlord is our first uncommon. Followed by Nivlis of the Breath. And a Farbog Boneflinger. And a rare is going to be another Havangul Runebinder. I will not read the card since we have already read it one time. Hey, there's that dude that we picked up in the pack. I think that was the first pack right there. And behind that we have a checklist card. And an uncommon flip, the Soul Caesar. Not C-A-E-S-E-R, but S-E-I-Z, whatever. Anyway, it's a 1-3 spirit with flying. When Soul Caesar deals combat damage to a player, you may transform it. If you do, attach it to target creature that player controls, so it becomes a an enchantment. That's interesting. Okay. Turns into the Ghastly Haunting. Wow. Look at the angles on the hands of this girl. They're like crooked and the elbows are bent at weird angles and things. Very cool. You can see how she almost instantly became possessed and turned into this thing which is no longer bound by the rules of, you know, the human body and biology and physics. You control enchanted creature. Okay? Not too bad. Alright, so we'll put that one back. We've got 3 packs left to go. Open. Oh, shoot. I didn't want to open the front. I should have been more specific when I asked it to open. My god, this pack is basically just getting destroyed. Okay, I'm going to try to get them back in here when I'm done. Don't know if that's going to work. Screeching Scab. That's just creepy. Absolutely creepy. Favor of the Woods. That is a big bear. Another Bar of the Door. Forge Devil. Not foil this time. A Midnight Guard. That's a pretty cool card, too. Whenever another creature enters the battlefield, untap him. That's not bad. Not bad at all. Ulvenwald Bear. Undying Evil. Griptide. Got ourselves a foil. That's 8 commons. There's a Harrowing Journey. Drogskull Captain. I like that. Look at that. It's a good motion shot right there. All of these things behind the guy are sort of flowing into the background. It really gives the perception that he's jumping forward towards us, the viewer. Very, very nice. That is cool. I like that one. Last uncommon is another Village Survivors. What is our rare? It's another mythic. We have had 4 mythics in this fat pack. This is absolutely bonkers. What do we have? We have Archangel's Light. 1 white and 7 gives us a sorcery. You gain 2 life for each card in your graveyard, then shuffle your graveyard into your library. Not overly powerful, but not bad. Not bad at all. Behind this is our, what, advertisement card? No, it's a token for once. Look at that. Okay, we have a human token. All right. Advertisement, check. Okay, it's a checklist card. So behind this we have a flip card. Yep, flip card. Flip uncommon. The Afflicted Deserter. 3-2 werewolf. At the beginning of each upkeep, if no spells were cast, transform him, and he transforms into the Werewolf Ransacker. A 5-4 werewolf, whenever this creature transforms into Werewolf Ransacker, you may destroy target artifact. Very cool. If that artifact is put into a graveyard this way, Werewolf Ransacker deals 3 damage to that artifact's controller, and then you flip him back if 2 or more spells were cast this turn. What is our foil card? It is going to be a foil common. Foil common Executioner's Hood. Still very cool looking. Ooh, wow, his eyes are glowing. Look at that. He's got glowy little eyeballs there. That's creepy. All right. Very, very cool. All right. Let's put these back. If I can get them back into this, like, completely destroyed pack right here. Some of you are probably wondering why, if you've never seen me open a pack of Magic cards, why I'm doing this anyway. It's because I like to keep all the cards in the packs they came in until I get ready to sort them into a complete set. That may be a week from now, it might be a year from now. if it's a lengthy time from now, it kind of gives me a way to come back in and reopen packs, because odds are pretty good I've forgotten what I got in the packs anyway. So it's kind of a way to double open a booster pack, which is fun. All right, Gruesome Discovery, our first card in here. Let's stop and talk about this one, because I think I've seen this thing before, but it's a really nice piece. It's one of those, like I said, it's hard sometimes to actually tell a story with a single frame of artwork, but it's really well done here. The only thing that sort of doesn't work well is it's called Gruesome Discovery, but it's really just a corpse. It's not like he's missing his head or something where it would be really gruesome, but I love just the fact that you've got this agony on this woman's face from discovering what I'm assuming is her husband or something like that. You can see the dress that she's kneeling down on the floor, kind of picking him up. It's on both sides. So he's kind of laying over her legs. I mean, it's a really, really good piece of art, and it works really well. I mean, it's very, very nice. John Stanko is the artist on that one. Really, really, really good piece of artwork there. A Near Heath Stalker. Crushing Vines, Erdwald Ripper, Stormbound Geist, Chant of the Skiffsang, Talons of Falconwrath. Looks like, what was that chick's name from X-Men? Lady Deathstrike. Highborn Ghoul. Love the neutral tone colors used to paint this one. Very nicely done. Gather the Townsfolk. First uncommon is Faith's Shield. Faith's Shield. Followed by Lingering Souls. And finally, a Thraven Heretic. Okay. All right, behind this we have our rare, which is going to be Seance. All right, it's an enchantment. It costs 2W2. At the beginning of each upkeep, you may exile target creature card from your graveyard. If you do, put a token on the battlefield that's a copy of that card, except it's a spirit in addition to its other types. Exile it at the beginning of the next end step. I like the fact that it's each upkeep, so you can do it on your opponent's upkeeps too. That's very, very nice. Very cool card. And behind that we have an advertisement, a checklist. Here's our flip cards. Khorne Villager becomes Moonscarred Werewolf once again. One pack remains in our Dark Ascension Fat Pack opening / Artistic Inspiration. I hope you guys have been inspired. I know that we've seen some amazing artwork this time, and I hope that you can take some of what you've learned here or seen here and apply it into your own artwork. We're going to start off with a Silver Claw Griffin. Spiteful Shadows. Another Executioner's Hood. Another Bar of the Door. Thought Scour. Very cool card. Always love me a good mill card. That's a nice one. Two cards of his library into their graveyard, and I get to draw a card. Gather the Townsfolk. Another Sightless Ghoul. Fires of Undeath. Falconwrath Torturer. Curse of Thirst is our first uncommon. Followed by the Thraven Heretic. And a Strangleroot Geist. And our final rare is going to be Curse of Misfortunes. We have not been misfortunate in this Fat Pack opening. All right. It is an enchant player that costs 1W4. At the beginning of your upkeep, you may search your library for a curse card that doesn't have the same name as a curse attached to an enchanted player. Put it onto the battlefield attached to that player. Then shuffle your library. Okay, well, that's kind of interesting. So you attach this to a player, and over the next few upkeeps, theoretically, you get to do even more horrible stuff to them with other curse cards. Okay, and behind this we have another human soul or human token, and we have a flippy flip. We have a flip card, the Chalice of Life. I think this is the first artifact flip we've seen. 3 mana, tap it, you gain 1 life, then if you have at least 10 or more, then your starting life total transform Chalice of Life. It transforms into... Oh, yes, I forgot there's a card behind that. The Chalice of Death. You can tap it and target player loses 5 life. Okay. And then we have a forest. Very, very, very cool. Overall, a monumental pack opening, or fat pack opening. Really thoroughly enjoyed it. Saw a lot of cards. Really thrilled with the number of mythics. We got 4 mythics out of 9 packs of cards. That's crazy. No idea if any of this stuff is worth anything. Frankly, it doesn't matter. We have seen some very, very, very cool artwork, and that is what these videos are all about. I hope that you guys have enjoyed this look into Dark Ascension and this fat pack opening. If you happen to have any comments or questions, please feel free to leave those in the comments section down below. Also, be sure to leave a thumbs up on this video and subscribe to AG Productions, and make sure to hit that bell so that you get notified every single time a new video gets posted. Also, if you're enjoying these videos that I produce, whether they be the Monster Fest videos or any other videos, please consider helping me by supporting me through Patreon. Your financial support would be greatly appreciated, and the link for that is down there in the video description. I would really, really appreciate your help. I want to thank you once again for watching. God bless you all. Have an amazing rest of the day, and I will see you all in the next video.